Joey with OMG Ubuntu here, and in this video I'm going to show you all of the great new features and improvements coming your way in Ubuntu 23.10. I think that sounds good. You're watching this video, so I think you do. Let's get into it. Ubuntu 23.10 is an interim release that gets 9 months of updates. No, it's not long, but it doesn't need to be, as Ubuntu 24.04 LTS is out next year, and that's supported for 5 years. Ubuntu 23.10 makes a major change to new installs that will mostly affect those who are new to the distro. Previously, a standard Ubuntu install would come with all of the software you need to do, well, pretty much anything, but not so in Ubuntu 23.10. Now, the minimal install is the default install. You must select the expanded installation option to install Ubuntu with apps like LibreOffice, Thunderbird, the Shotwell Photo Manager and Image Editor, GNOME Calendar and the Transmission BitTorrent Client, games, and apps for playing music and watching videos. But if you don't need or want any of that, then select the default install to get basic essentials like a web browser, text editor, and a terminal. But when you do want more apps, you can fire up the brand new App Center that's included in this release. App Center is a Flutter-based replacement for the poorly regarded Ubuntu software. It's been built from the ground up to provide a fast, fluid, responsive front end to Canonical's Snap Store. You're not limited to Snap apps though. When performing searches, you're able to see and install traditional deb software available in the Ubuntu archives and make use of filters to switch between formats too. Updating device firmware is easier in this release thanks to Ubuntu's new firmware updater tool, which is also built using Flutter. Leveraging the Linux vendor firmware service, this app lets you see info on current firmware versions, check for firmware updates, and install them should you wish. A new dynamic workspace indicator replaces the old activities label in the top bar. The indicator elegantly animates as you move between workspaces to let you know which one you're on. You can also switch workspaces by hovering over the icon and scrolling with your mouse or touchpad. The quick settings menu now lets you turn your keyboard backlight on or off, while the submenu slider lets you adjust backlight intensity to your desired level. GNOME devs have given Nautilus a major speed boost with faster thumbnail generation. Search results are now returned in milliseconds, and it's easier to expand searches to include more locations, while the new full-height sidebar is the new home for the transfer widget, just so you know where to look next time you're copying that multi-gig file. Pertinent information about your computer is contained within a new compact system details dialog accessed from the Settings app. The Settings app also benefits from a raft of other changes, including a new privacy panel that groups together controls over how your system behaves behind the scenes. The keyboard layout viewer has been overhauled pretty dramatically, in my opinion, to make it far more intuitive to find out which key presses are needed to type obscure characters. And it's finally possible to edit and manage saved Wi-Fi network connection info when wireless connectivity is turned off. It's taken forever and a day, but I'm pleased to say Ubuntu finally supports quarter tiling. You can now nestle app windows into quadrants neatly by dragging them to the corners of your screen, making use of an auto-suggest pop-up to speed things up further. And yes, it supports horizontal half-tiling as well. In Ubuntu 23.10, the Firefox Snap runs in a native Wayland mode by default and not the X-Wayland compatibility mode as before. This banishes blurry icons and website text and intros full support for touchscreen manipulation. No new Ubuntu release will be complete without a new Linux kernel, and we get version 6.5 here plus Mesa 23.2 for better than ever gaming and graphics performance. Finally, the adventurous amongst you will be pleased to see Ubuntu on ZFS support has returned in 23.10, and it's possible to now use TPM-backed disk encryption, though both features remain experimental and best used with caution. Of course, you can do more with Ubuntu than what comes out of the box, so be sure to go and sample the awesome first-party Linux apps that are available online, many of which can be found on FlatHub, all compatible with this release. And that, my friends, is that, an overview of what's new in Ubuntu 23.10. Is there a feature you're particularly excited by? Change you're unsure of? Let me know what you think of this release down in the labyrinth of public opinion below. Hopefully you won't need a ball of string to find your way back out though. You can also let me know what your hopes are for Ubuntu 24.04 LTS, which is out next April. We're likely to see the first version of an all-snap immutable Ubuntu base, which is pretty exciting. That said, don't panic unnecessarily as a legacy desktop installer will continue to be provided. If you liked this video, please consider subscribing for more great Ubuntu related content. And if you think this video might be informative, useful, etc. to other people out there in the world, consider sharing it on your social media because it makes me feel warm and fuzzy inside, like I've just eaten an awful lot of pizza. Otherwise, that's it for now. Don't forget to check out the blog and I'll see you on the next one.